Well, here we go. Another world champion to crown. It's men's épée, and it's Italy v. France. For Italy, Davide Di Biroli, Federico Bismara, Gabriele Cipini, and Andrea Santarelli. And the team from France. Gaetan Billa, Romain Canon, Alexander Bardonet, and Yannick Borel. So tonight for Italy, it will be Cipini, Santarelli, and Di Biroli to start. Federico Bismara in reserve. For France, it's Romain Canon, Yannick Borel, and Alexander Bardonet, and Gaetan Billa in reserve. We'll get our team salutes here. And that's the pleasantries done with, because this will be a big battle. It'll be Davide Di Biroli to open and close for Italy. Alexander Bardonet will open for France, and Yannick Borel will close. As we get ready for our first leg of nine in this gold medal match, some news breaking, and that is that the rules have been changed in the FIE. It will no longer be compulsory to shake hands after a match. You can go to the on guard line and salute your opponent, and that is that's the way things are from now on. Thought you'd find that interesting. Now, during the day today, Italy started against the Czech Republic, had a tough match there, then defeated Venezuela. France started against Kazakhstan, and then in the semifinals against Korea. Korea went on to win the bronze medal. So first leg underway here. Referees are Mikhail Pagiev and Dilorum Turdikulova of Uzbekistan. Now in every match, bar one, that we had in the quarterfinals and semifinals today, we had a passivity call in the opening period, and Davide Di Biroli breaks that mold right there. Well, we may yet get a passivity call here in the opening period. There it is. Yellow P card shown to both sides of the piece. Both ends of the piece, I should say. Bardonet going for a hit to the foot. Looks like he lost his footing in the process there for a sec. Well, DiVaroli just missed over the right shoulder of Bardonet. Clock's going to wind down here in the opening period. One for DiVaroli, one for Bardonet, and 1-1. We roll into the second. It will be Gabriele Cimini on for Italy. He'll face Yannick Borel. And Cimini had been the reserve in quarterfinals and semifinals. A bit of a struggle for Federico Vismara in the semifinals. And Cimini to start. Has been out for 4 or 5 months, nursing a broken ankle. And this World Championships is his return to fencing. On the attack there. Ooh. Borel comes in on a flash attack. Misses, stops, and then able to find the target. That flash attack again, and Cimini waiting with a counterattack on the other end. Double. Steps in with a big disengage, finds the target, and a strong start here for him. Just beats the blade out of the way, takes a step in. Well, Tamini drawing the attack from Burrell, picking that attack up and getting the riposte to the shoulder. That's a classic Burrell move there. Just force your way through. Blade work. But the final action of flick to the shoulder from Tamini. Oh, and a hit to the foot. Comes in on a high line and then just flicks down to the foot. Double. Case of Burrell fighting off the original attack, then Tamini fighting off Burrell's attack, and Burrell starts back in and gets hit. Double. And that will do it for the second period. 16 points in total scored in that 3 minutes. 8 for Gabriele Tamini, 8 for Yannick Burrell, and 9-9. We roll into the third. Andrea Santarelli on for Italy. Romain Canon on for France. Santarelli has just been fantastic today in the quarterfinal match against Czech Republic. Santarelli ended that match on a plus 12 indicator. And I've asked if there is something wrong with Valerio Cuomo, and I haven't gotten an answer yet. It's possible he was injured during the individual event earlier in the week. But Santarelli, who we presumed had retired, looks like he's never left. And a double to open. Ooh, Santarelli lost his footing there. Just come on in.
Angiak. Pre Ale.
Big flesh attack there from a close distance from Santarelli, and this is what he's been doing all day. Well, Canoon says, I'll give that a try. And Santarelli says, well, how do you like this parry riposte? Well, Santarelli takes us to the target score of 15. And that was pretty impressive from Andrea Santarelli. Bardonnay back on for France to face Gabriele Cimini, who looked pretty unstoppable himself in the second leg. When it looked like Yannick Borel was going to run away with it, Cimini came in and scored 8 points to Borel's 8. Bardonnay just misses to the left. Well, Bardonnay going into low line, going for a hit to the foot. And Cimini with a counter to his shoulder. Well, as Cimini was going by there, you've got one opportunity and one motion to hit your opponent as he passes. And Bardonnay did exactly that. Cimini draws Bardonnay in. And then a hit to the near target, just under the guard. And then the foot. What next? him, and he just working the blade, working the blade. And in for the strike. 5-1. One for Chimney. One for Bardinet. 20-12. We roll into the fourth. Davide Divaroli back on for Italy. He'll face Romain Canon. Managed only two in the third against Santarelli, and he's going to need, and France, they're going to need better than that. He's Olympic champion in 2021, became world champion in 2022. Comes in, does that little duck thing. And as he comes up, Divaroli strikes. Well, Canon tries a flesh attack, pulls his arm back on the way in. And Divaroli with the counter to the mask. Double. But thus far, both of Romain Canon's points in this fifth leg have come from doubles. Another double. Well, that will take us out of fifth into the sixth. It will be Andrea Santarelli back on. Let's see if Yannick Borel can handle him. So in that last leg, DiGrilli had five, Canone had three. All three were on doubles. Another double. And I'm beginning to wonder if the very long wait, another double. Between the semifinals and the final match is having an effect here, at least on France. They seem a bit flat. The men's Epee semifinals finished around 2:30 in the afternoon. So that's more than 4 hours between that and the start of this match. Taking the blade as he comes in. That'll show you. Santarelli, his timing is absolutely perfect. Burrell trying to fashion a double there, but just goes over the top. Santarelli takes us out of the sixth. Five for Santarelli, five for Burrell. 30, 20. We go into the seventh, and France is running out of road here. Chimney, Canon. And Chimney, just the whole Italian squad is just on fire tonight. and all of Roman Cannon's hits have come on doubles. He's managed two in the third and three in the fifth. And that is Roman Cannon's first solo hit in a gold medal match. In this gold medal match. And it comes in the seventh leg of nine. Second one. Big beat to Jiminy's weapon. In with the strike. He's pressing now. Draws the attack from Cannon. Takes the blade. And turns with a flick to the back. Cannon coming in, going to the low line, and then flicking up underneath. Hitting the near target. Maybe Roman Cannon has finally refound his timing here. Rediscovered it. Double. Double will do it. That takes us to 35. One in the eighth and penultimate leg. Andrea Santarelli, who's been an absolute star all day today for this Italian squad. He'll face Alexander Bardinet. Bardinet, as it stands, is on a minus four indicator. Double. Thank you. Bardonet's attack comes up short. Santarelli gets the parry, gets the riposte. Hit to the foot. Perfect. Referee calls halt. There's no hit given. Again, Bardonet falls short, gets picked off. This out. Bardonet gets a flick in there to on the arm. So he's got at least one solo hit. Santarelli went past. Bardonet couldn't. Couldn't get to him. Go into the ninth and final leg. Davide Di Vairoli will face Yannick Borel. We're going to have to wait until next season before we get to see a double. See how this new rule change in the FIE will affect things, how it will play out. Because as of today, in individual matches and in team matches as well, it's not compulsory, no longer compulsory to shake hands, and it's not a cardable offense. If you don't want to shake hands, you don't have to, but you do have to go to the on guard line and salute your opponent. Flush attack.
Ale.
Italy on the cusp of two gold medals in one night. Hughes Obrey. Like, what are these people on? Absolutely commanding performance from this Italian side. The roof is going to come off of this place. And there it is, a double will do it. 45-32, Italy. Our men's épée team world champion for 2023. What an amazing show. Official from Swiss Timing. It's silver for France. Let's see, France is on, is world number one, and on 384. Italy is number two, world number two, and on 309. So I'm not sure if it's possible. Hungary today was defeated by Venezuela, and they're world number three. So I'm not sure this will necessarily change the rankings, because France is getting points too. I mean, this has been a great World Championships. I wish all World Championships, fencing World Championships, could be like this, or could have been like this. This is certainly the best since 2019 in Budapest. Especially, the thing is the people. This place has been rammed. All the day sessions, all the finals, finals have been sold out. Tomorrow is our final day. Women's team Sabre